Good morning, students. Here we are going to see the third chapter of physics, that is laws of motion. Okay, I think this topic is familiar to you. You have already learned in 10th standard, right? And here these are the topics to be covered in this chapter. So first, initially, introduction, logical connection between laws of Newton, free body diagram, law of conservation of momentum, role of frictional forces, centripetal and centrifugal forces, and origin of centrifugal force. Okay, so the first thing is introduction. So our topic is what? Laws of motion. So initially we have to know what is motion. What is motion? Motion is one of the key topic in physics. Okay, and we know it generally, everything in the universe moves, right? But it may be a small amount of movement and very, very slow, but movement does happen. Yes or no? Yes. So, if we are the person standing still here, right? But the earth is, which means what? The earth is rotating our sun. And the sun is also moves around the galaxy. So, if this movement at all, it never stops, right? So, in physics, the motion is about only what? Forces. Okay. So, what is a force? So what exactly a force? The force is nothing but it is a pushing or pulling action that can make things to move and change direction and also what? Changing the shape also. That is nothing but what? Force. For example, if you consider, if a book is at rest, right? Which means what? It will not move until the force is applied on it. Yes or no? In other words, we should say what is that? To move an object, the forces applied on it. Yes or no? That is a famous philosopher, Aristotle, said that force causes motion. What do you mean by force causes motion? Whenever the object will be in motion, it needs a what? Force. That is nothing but force causes motion. Okay. Back in the 15th century, Galileo said that force is not required to maintain a motion. Which means what? Whenever the object to be in motion, in that time the force is not required. This is what Galileo said. Okay. But Aristotle's view is what? Force causes motion. But in Galileo's view, he said force is not required to maintain a motion. And Galileo proved, which means he demonstrated a simple experimental based on this, force is not required to maintain a motion.
Look at this picture. This is the simple experiment demonstrated by Galileo. In the first picture, when a ball rolls from the top of an inclined plane to its bottom, after reaching the ground, it moves some distance and continues to move on to another inclined plane of same angle of inclination. Now look at the second picture. The rough surface is changed to smooth surface. Now what will happen? The ball will reach almost the same height. Suppose the angle of inclination is reduced, which means we are reducing the angle here. That time the ball travels longer distance in the second plane. Suppose there is no angle in the second plane. At that time the ball moves forever in the horizontal direction, which means the ball goes on infinity. Okay. Now coming to Aristotle's view, force causes motion. But Galileo proved in this experiment, force is not required to maintain motion. So he said, an object can be in motion even without a force acting on it. By the conclusion is, Aristotle coupled the motion with force, while Galileo decouple the motion and force. This is the Galileo's experiment.